Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So some of you ask me, Brittany, what are you gonna do when you run out of things to organize? And I'll tell you, you start over. It's been 2 years since I've done a bathroom organization video, and this time I wanted to tailor it to organizing a small bathroom. I know a lot of you out there are working with a smaller space, and I like a good organization challenge, so that's what we're doing today. If you are new here and you enjoy organization videos, or if you enjoy watching other people organize, then make sure you are subscribed to my channel. And with all that said, let's jump into it. So as with any organization project, I always like to start by clearing out and cleaning out the space. So you start with a nice blank canvas. So what I did here is I emptied everything out from the drawers, under the sink, the cabinets. I got all of it out. I found some really random things under here. It's always so funny, the things that you'll find as you're organizing. So after I did that, I cleaned everything off. So I just wiped down the countertops, the sink, the toilet, the shower. I got everything ready. I decided to put down a drawer liner under the sink because this area was a little grimy, and I just feel like having this here will make it look cleaner, neater, and will make it easier to clean up in the future. So I just cut it to the size, put it in here, so easy to do. Since we're here, we're gonna start with the under the sink organization. And when you have a small space, in order to maximize it, you want to utilize all the vertical space. So a couple different options here. I found this stackable shelf that rolls out, which is a great option. Or they have this type of a shelf where you can just put baskets on the top and on the bottom, and this will double the space you have. I use this organizer to put some of my bathroom essential products. To continue on with the stacking theme, I am using these clear glass jars to put Q-tips and cotton pads.
My crew? Supervising?
Oops. Supervisors. This is the lead supervisor. He says the lighting's off.
I have this magazine rack, which I am using to store washcloths. You just roll them up, and then this fits nicely under the sink, and it keeps your washcloths contained. I have this pretty cloth bin that I'm using to store my hair care products. And then the last thing I am putting under the sink is this wire hot tools organizer. It hangs on the inside of the cabinet door, so it utilizes that unused space, and it's a very convenient place to put your curling iron, blow dryer, straightener, whatever hot tools you use can be stored away there. Now, I do want to point out, if you have a pedestal sink and no under the sink storage, you still do have options. I found these storage units that can fit right around your pedestal sink, and that will add on storage for you. Another thing you can do is add a piece of cloth around the sink, and that will give you kind of a hidden space where you can store things. If you're working with a small space, another thing I recommend you do is not store extra supplies in the bathroom. Instead, what I like to do is store these in my laundry room. I have more space there, so I have these containers where I put extra paper towels and extra toilet paper, so they're not taking up precious real estate within the bathroom. But I do like to have at least a couple extra rolls of toilet paper so no one's left in a precarious situation.
Babe, I need some toilet paper. Anybody? Help? Toilet paper, please.
So the solution I found for this is this toilet paper hanger that clips onto the side of the toilet bowl. It's compact, convenient, and it will hold 2 rolls of toilet paper, which I think is a good amount to keep extra in the bathroom. The wall behind the toilet is also valuable real estate. So if you don't have something here, it's definitely a space you want to utilize. You can put floating shelves here, or you can even just adhere bins onto the wall. So I found these wire baskets and I put them on the wall, and I'm using this space to roll up and store some extra towels. Now moving on to the shower, there are so many options to add extra storage space. One thing I found that I love are these shelves that go right in the corner of your shower area. They are suctioned on here, very secure, it's not going anywhere, and this adds 2 extra shelves of storage space. Another thing I found, which may be my favorite of this entire video, is this shower curtain that has pockets in it that you can use to store all of your shower supplies. So you can put your shampoo, conditioner, razors, shaving creams, all of your different shower supplies can fit into these little pockets. And if you don't need this much storage, I also found a smaller unit that has just 6 pockets that you could hang on your shower curtain rod. Now moving on to the bathroom countertop. I generally like to keep very little on the countertops, but when you're working with a small space, you're gonna have to keep some stuff out. One thing I found for this is a glass shelf that sticks onto the wall. So it's a damage-free, drill-free shelf. I just stuck this onto the wall in the space between the mirror and the countertop, and this added a ton of extra storage space. So you could put some of your bathroom supplies, or you could even put decorative items like candles and things like that on the space. But I just think it's a really easy way to add additional storage. To make things look a little bit prettier, I use this mirror as a tray, and on top of this, I put my soap and body lotion, and I found these pretty reusable glass containers and labeled them. I think it's just a nice touch, and it's just a lot less expensive in the long run to refill your soap rather than buying new soap every time. I found this toothbrush holder, which I really like because not only does it hold your toothbrushes, but it also holds your toothpaste. This little contraption I found, I think, is so cool. It clips onto the outlet and adds a little shelf. And I think this is a perfect space for Ryan to keep his razor so it's out of the way. Other little finishing touches and extras I like to do in the bathroom. First is, it's always great to have fresh flowers, but we all know I cannot keep those alive. So my next best thing is fake flowers, but in particular, I think that fake orchids always look the most realistic. So I found this one from Target. I think it's so pretty and it just adds a little something extra. If your bathroom also doubles as a guest bathroom, one thing I like to do is have a little container where I keep extra toiletries, just little things that your guests can grab. It's just a nice little added touch. One thing I like to do in the trash bin is I line it with multiple trash bags. So every time I go to take out the trash, I pull out that bag and a new one is there waiting and ready. In case you were late on this bandwagon, I feel that having poopery in your guest bathroom especially is a must. If you don't know what that is, I will link it below and you can thank me later. So those are my ideas for today. Let me know if you enjoyed it by giving this video a thumbs up, and a couple quick announcements. First, I'm planning out my content for 2018, so let me know in the comments if you have any requests for specific videos you would like to see me do. The other thing is, I'm finally going to be changing my channel name to Brittany Vasseur. That should be happening in the next couple weeks, so look out for it. I don't know why I'm so nervous to change my channel name. It shouldn't really be a big deal, but to me, it's a big deal. So anyway, don't be alarmed if you see a video pop up in your feed and it has a different name. Still me. I've been really into Snapchat lately, so make sure you are following me there as well as Instagram and Twitter. And with all that said, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon with a new video. Bye.